Hello.
Namaste.
Namaste.
Namaste. Time has come again.
Porto Alegre. Lots of love.
So nice to be connected. We're talking today about the importance of a sense of humor, because what we're actually involved in is no laughing matter. It's not a laughing matter. We're in a very intense place, and yet we have to find humor in something that's not a laughing matter.
Mm-hmm.
You know, we have to find ways to raise our spirits, and it's every day gets a little tougher until we get into a space where we feel like we're surrendered to it. And then it's a totally different feeling. So, and that a sense of humor is essential. And also a sense of ritual. Have you got your candle ready for the meditation? So, you know, in Pune, when Osho was in his body, it was always the meditation. We came freshly showered. We were in clean clothes. We took pride, and we took care, and we wanted to be at our best, you know, when we meditated, and it helped the quality of our meditation. It's not that it just helped. It just does something to the spirit. So I want to encourage you there, you know, make our time together a ritual. Make sure that you have some kind of Mother Nature representative in the room with you if you can. That means a plant or a flame, or any of your beloved pets that you have there. These are the creatures that keep us connected to Mother Earth and keep us connected to a wider perspective than the one that our ego finds itself in right now. So,
and thanks for the jokes that some of you sent on our Facebook wall.
Do you know any? Can you remember any?
Oh yeah. Yeah. No. and also that's a good place to post good news. You know,
yeah.
Things that happen to you right now that wouldn't have happened to you otherwise, and the good that comes out of this, so we can inspire each other and find a place where we get some good news,
yeah,
where we can share them.
And, you know, dress up, put some nice clothes on, don't let it get you down, you know, because that's where we don't need to go. So, you know, nice, don't be ashamed to enjoy this time.
Oh, one joke was,
mm-hmm,
I'm sure you've seen it, it's a cartoon, and the guy is saying, well, I wonder where I'm going to go for Easter. In the living room or in the dining room?
That's right, yeah.
He didn't know the third option, to go in.
Go in. That's
so
the only
that's
place
where
to
we
go.
are.
That's
Yes.
it. That's the escape, is to go in. Yeah, right, good. Shall we chant together? We were speaking about whether we continue to experiment with the sound Aum, which is the three syllable sounds, A, O, and M, or whether we just continue with the mantra Aum as it sounds, with long resonance on the M sound.
And we've looked at your comments. It was interesting to read that it seemed like pretty balanced. Some of you said you felt more at home and at ease with Aum, and some of you said, oh, Aum really feels like the right resonance for you. So I feel just stay with whatever feels right for you.
No, let's do all the same today.
Okay.
We go for that later. Let's all be together. Let's do Aum. That's good. Let's experiment. Let's take this experiment a little further. And today we continue with Aum, and with the mudra, with the open arms, bringing it into the channel and then into the body, resonating wherever you feel it. For me, it resonates right here in the center of my chest. And let's see. Let's see how it
yes.
feels today. So it's a moment to slow down. Shall we just take a moment? You know, Deva and I just be quiet here for a moment so you can hear the sounds that are around us. We just go into a few moments of silence so you can hear the birds and the monkeys and nothing.
Mm-hmm. And the cicadas.
Nature is so alive here. With the mantra Aum, Aum, and then we will continue with the Gayatri mantra, the seventh chakra, and then we will come back to the mantra Aum for the final part of the meditation. So take your time, check out how you're feeling your body, you straighten your spine, and take a deep breath. Sound. Bringing the arm of light into the channel and into the body. Good. beloved, turn to each other and you continue to chant. Take a moment to look into each other's eyes as you chant.
Closing our eyes. Just enjoying the sensations in the body.
Your spine straight, back straight. Raising your gaze to the third eye, behind your closed eyes, up there into the light.
Probably timeless.
Bye.
Um, sa,
Again, come home. Join Deva with the mantra Om. Breathe in rhythm with Deva. This is a song that you haven't asked for yet.
I've been asking.
David's been asking for it. It's an old song. It's called The Other Side.
Time like now, in my heart you will always exist, calling me on somehow. Say away. For love, I'm ready to fly, and I was never asking for much. was given the sky. I sail away over the ocean, over the ocean of time. Sail away over the mountain to the other side, to the other side. I never saw the moon till I looked in your eyes. I never saw myself so clear. Clouds of loneliness all swept aside. I watched them all disappear. Sail away over the ocean, over the ocean of time. Sail away over the mountain to
to say. It's a funny little scene going on here by the swimming pool. There's a swimming pool here, and above the pool there's a bird's nest and two beautiful little birds taking care of the nest. Obviously got eggs in there, and they're backwards and forwards, and very protective. And every afternoon comes a vulture from the beach, and he only wants to come dip his head in the water, really, you know. He's a big ugly guy, but of course he's beautiful in himself.
I actually posted a picture just earlier.
You did?
Yes.
He comes and he just hangs by the pool.
His mate today.
He did. And you know what happens? The little ones, they're amazingly protective. You know, I'm just seeing more nature than I've ever seen, I think. So I'm just seeing the way these two guys protect their space, you know, and it's like, hey, it's okay, there's room for everyone, don't panic. The guy just wants a drink, you know. But it's like, full on, get out of my space, you know.
I think I caught it. I think I might be able to post it. The way the little one was trying to chase them away.
One nice thing you could try if you are there with your family, or, you know, if it gets a little stressy or tense there sometimes, sure it can. You know what I found to be really nice, and that is memories. talk about memories. Talk about nice memories. When there's a not, it's just a nice feeling. It just makes you feel good. So I really recommend you try it. David and I were talking a bit earlier about some memories, just people, or you know, just going back in time to some beautiful moments. Make this.
What about all this here and now thing?
You know, you can be in the here and now. No, that's a good point. But I mean, that is the point, that we can be in the here and now, exploring our memories. That's the way. That's what we're doing. We're actually in the here and now. There's nowhere else to go right now. You know, so only in the mind, and we do not want to get lost in the mind. We really don't want to get lost in the mind. And if you find yourself getting lost in the mind, there's your mantra. Open the door to your heart. Let the thoughts go and let the mantra take you back into the moment, back into the sacred spirit that you are, that we all are. Use the mantras. They are tools. You know that. They're not just songs. They're much, much more. Gift from God, from the great divine. It's a key into our soul spirit.
Mm.
So they're precious. Okay. I think that's it for today, huh? So if your neighbor needs a little water sometime, don't be scared to give him some water. All good.
Even if he or she looks like a vulture. Have a beautiful rest of the day, that's the or night or beginning of the day for the Aussies amongst us. And we send you all our love.
Be happy.
Yes. Namaste.
Namaste.